responsible without your money or not. Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hand on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hands on the clock. Come like a bat out of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like I'm finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best. If it ain't me, then you need you a confession, you a mess. You ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you, a cheetah, run up and I'm airing the scene. And I feel just like Vegeta Prince, and I'm an heir to the seat. I mean, for real. Test the driver's soft, so I don't even grab the wheel. That's a lot on my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Mean I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this loose think the fresh, but ain't half the man as well. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hand on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hands on the clock. Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't want to bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you. I hate to break but me and myself talk too. I blow away the competition like a bowl of hot soup. And there's no catch, I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the car with dash. I shake a pic, told them all, you ain't first, you last. Little boy, that's facts, I'ma grow that cash to my money.
Coverage of the National Football League is on the air. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Detroit Lions and the New Orleans Saints.
They're set to kick off.
The shadow's starting to get a bit longer. Week 10 of the NFL season is here, and we're underway on EA Sports.
Taken from about the 12. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
At their own 28-yard line.
Touchdown, New Orleans! A great effort there. He his 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Saints have taken the early lead.
Well, they said they wanted to have some explosive runs. How about that one to start the game?
And I would say on the defensive sideline, there's a lot to answer for. Because you spend all week saying, stop the run. I don't care who you're playing. You don't want to get run over. You don't want to get run past. And they have both overcommitting in the secondary, and he just went stepping past them and is still running, essentially.
One play, and he hits pay dirt.
Naeem Hines, his first carry. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, in their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here.
This is Hines. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 13-yard gain yet again, just like last play.
Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Play fake. Here's Love. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
A gain of 9.
Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
On second down, it's Hines. And they can't bring him down. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game. And it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
Yeah, he was able to shed one tackle, but could not get away from there.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming. To pass, here's Jordan Love. And he's gonna go down. He sacked back at the 24. Larry Ogunjobi in for the sack.
Well, it's about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down.
So, yes, it's only 3, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there, because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things, because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
And he returns this to the 22.
At their own 22-yard line.
Jump!
getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it? Big time jaunt. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. A shotgun snap for Watson. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. It'll be a Saints first down on a pickup of 13.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got our bike up.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. Another try after the first down sack. Watson flush to his right. Able to locate his running back open downfield. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A gain there of 30 big ones. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports.
7, Lions 3.
They'll run on first down. Key. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Left side into the hands of his tight end. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 13-yard line. Really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. From the red zone now, Watson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. That time he was looking for Jerry Jeudy, and now it's second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Off of play action, it's Watson rolling to his right. Oh, he's trying for Smith-Schuster, but it's intercepted. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And he will take this all the way up past the 40-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out. down to the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. It's a loss of four. Now third down.
This defense is really floating around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Working out of the gun, Love. He's got his man, that's Hardman. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They run with Hines. And he'll take this one down to the 36.
Naheem Hines.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
On second down now. It's Taylor, and good running, going to get this down close to a first at the Saints 27. 9 yards the pick up there, and it's a first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
Now left side on the swing pass, and it's a fumble. The Saints say they have it, and they do. Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think they should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty good at finding ways to knock it out.
And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13. The last run got a couple here, second and 8. Taylor. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up first and goal. 2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. Reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
Gain on the play leads to second and goal at the 4-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. Taylor, and he'll get into the end zone, touchdown Detroit. Jonathan Taylor, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Lions have taken the lead. No success on first down. He couldn't get any yardage. They give it to him again, and he finds the end zone.
Sometimes it just has to be persistence, doesn't it? And you know who else helps with that? Offensive line. After a team's been stuffed, the last thing they want to do is go to a different play call. They want to come back and do it again and show that they can dominate the line of scrimmage.
Joey Sly set to kick off.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. And a short kick taken at about the 16.
Oh, a good-looking return set up here.
Take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah. Will they make up for it? So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Out of the gun, Watson. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20.
Boy, a pair of big plays here. This one going for 29.
And this is caught at the 8. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts, as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one.
7-yard line.
So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. From the gun, here's Watson, buying time to his left. And now he's going to use his legs. And the Saints are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Second and goal from inside the 5. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Stops short, down at the 1. Had the great move, but couldn't get all the way to the end zone. Now a signal and a timeout call, as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play. On third down, Key. And this time he is in.
Yes.
A great play there in the final seconds of the first half. And once again, the Saints are back out in front. And that makes it 14-10.
Makes the score Saints 14, Lions 10. Set to kick off.
Maybe time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
First down, love to pass. It's complete to Brown, right side. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
Keith Brown. He's taken out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. Play of the half, Love.
Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report.
Ulbrich Grossa set to kick off.
It'll be Lions football to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. They run once more with Taylor. 7 yards there and a first down.
He's had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They run with Taylor. 15 yards for the Lions there and a first down.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game. First and 10, Taylor now. And he's going to get this one down to the 45.
Jonathan Taylor.
Give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
On second down, it's Taylor. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
On first down, it's Taylor. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
So they hit pay dirt, but don't count it yet. There's laundry on the field. We'll see what the penalty flag is about. So retract the yardage and retract the touchdown.
And retract the chunk play. Big strike there to get the touchdown. Now they've got to take it back and see if they've got another one still in their arsenal.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. From the gun, it's Taylor. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
You've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and 6. Love from the gun. Fourth down after the New Orleans defense holds serve.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over
them. Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
And his kick is good. And the lead is down to one now at 14-13. So a decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged three out of it, but they inch a bit closer.
Yeah, but still lots of time to go in this one. That's why you hear that clapping on the sidelines, right? Hey, got some points. As you said, inching their way back in. Time left to go out and get that victory.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
At their own 26-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
So a decent game, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. From the gun, Watson. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. They've done a good job on these receivers, pretty much held them in check. They're a little too close for comfort.
And you're always looking for a play to get you going, right? You're looking for someone to make one. But maybe this penalty, this pass interference call, that can help shake them loose.
So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A good response by the defense, sending them backwards after that huge gain last play. Throwing on second and 14, Watson. That's going to be caught, and he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints' touchdown. Juju Smith-Schuster with touchdown number 8 on the year, and the Saints add on to their lead. And with that, the lead is up to 8.
Makes the score Saints 21, Lions 13. Aldrick Rosa set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Rosas on to kick it away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6.
First down.
On first and 10, Love sliding out of the pocket. Now he's going to throw deep right side.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Throwing again. Love. He'll find Taylor. That's complete. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving. Scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They'll run on first down. Taylor, and he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
A gain of 6 there on first.
6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4 at the Saints' 32-yard line.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Working with a 2nd and 4. They give to Taylor out of the gun. And only able to get 2 here. Stopped at the 30. Charles, this one, not over, certainly, but you set the magic number earlier in this game at 20 points, said that they would need to hold them right around that marker under it. What are you seeing here?
Well, that number is still in play because we said, okay, 20 or under gives them a chance to win, right on pace for being in that range, and guess what? They've got a shot.
The Lions on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. And he's able to pick up the 1st down here before he goes down at the 26. They're able to convert with a gain of 4.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? Olave's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on 3rd down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. First down. It's Taylor. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Oh, pardon. That play brought back memories. Watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him for a loss as well here. And one of the reasons they lead in the 4th quarter, plays like that.
Yeah, it took a little more time off the clock, making him do it that way, didn't they?
25 yards that time.
Set, ready.
They'll look to run with Taylor. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up 2nd and goal. So stuff from the 2. Now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
2nd and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Again, it'll be Taylor. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Jonathan Taylor with his 2nd touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Lions are a 2-point conversion away from tying this game. Here we go now as we get set for a big 2-point conversion. They're going to try and run for it. And he will get into the end zone again. And he seems to have a nose for it as he gets both the touchdown and the two-point conversion.
Joey Sly set to kick off.
A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. Pulls it in at the 13. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
At their own 26-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this fourth quarter to try to grab that lead back. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
At the 26-yard line.
And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. After the run, Watson gonna throw. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he is gonna have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First time they've looked his way in this game. He comes through picking up the first. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
A lot of times, just that first read that you have, maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Throwing again is Watson. Eluding the pressure right. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A gain of 13. It's a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
They're able to push forward for about 4 down to the 37. Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6.
A gain of 4.
It's now a play fake, and it's Watson. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 27-yard line.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to 1.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. Let's go, baby. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. On first down, Watson. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. Now Watson. And he's going to look that one in one-handed. What a catch for the touchdown.
Hey, that score deserves our respect, deserves our excitement. But I'm looking at the clock and I'm thinking, there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit more time off. Now on the other sideline, you start to get the crew together and say, this is what we practiced a two-minute drill for, right?
Yeah, you hope you've been in that situation before, and if you haven't, you just have the confidence, hey, let's go down there and get this thing done. But boy, that's a big score right there to give them the advantage.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Second and 8.
The play fake, Love. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. Obviously a big first down right there.
Yeah, they still got to hustle. They got to get up to the line of scrimmage and get set. But I don't think necessarily you need to spike it, but they've got to continue to move quickly.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 10 more there and another first down.
Okay, there's 3 timeouts left, right?
Think you got to use one here, don't you?
No doubt about it. I'd use one right here.
Back to Taylor on first down. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number 2. They'll run on first down. It's Taylor.
I know they got a little yardage there, but I'm not sure their investment is right. They're still running the football, and I'm not sure there's enough time to continue to do that.
And a solid run down inside the 30. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game.
Third down.
And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. He'll look to throw, letting one go deep for the end zone. And he's got it. It's caught for a touchdown. And they have taken the lead here in the final seconds.
Yes, sir. That touchdown puts him in striking distance. And let me tell you something. Forget being conservative here. Go for it. Go for 2.
Well, going for it on the road. Want to win it right now.
Want to win it right now. Have the momentum. Go ahead and get it done.
And now they're going to go for 2 and a possible win as this crowd rises to make things difficult. They'll try and run it in. And he's going to get in for the 2 points. It was an incredibly gutsy call, but they've taken the lead by a point late in the game.
Joey Sly set to kick off.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown.
Made at the 25-yard line. The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking 2 plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one. Whether you're able to get into field goal range, or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary. But you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
We'll see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. One last throw here for Watson, and that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock. That time he was looking for Jerry Jeudy. That'll bring up second down. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Of course, they have the option, and they choose to not take the penalty.
They like the results of the play that they just ran, and they elect to let them stand.
Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated.